One of the most eccentric players that comes to mind for me, Shaquille O'Neal. I mean, we could talk about his personality probably for days, but something about Shaq that I love is that he can rock a fur coat. I mean, can anybody else rock a fur coat?
Not at 7'2". We've seen him in his own rap videos. We've seen him as a news anchor. We've seen him.
His performance at NBA All-Star.
Oh my gosh, let's pull up the video right now because that was amazing.
And now, for the Western Conference, a 15-time All-Star, center, and one of the most dominant players in the history of the NBA, from your Phoenix Suns, the Big Shaq himself, Shaquille O'Neal.
So Jabberwockies were huge this year, and he, knowing how well he dances, had to bring them on stage.
He's a great dancer.
He is a great dancer, and you gotta imagine, like, I can't do anything close to that, and that's 7-foot frame. Like, that's impressive to be able to have that fluidity. Look at that.
I mean, he must have practiced for a long time. A couple run-throughs on this, what do we think?
Yeah, are you kidding me? Although it is God-given, like, that is natural talent right there. Oh my God.
I mean, and what I love is he's still going strong. Who doesn't love the TNT gang? I mean, they all have strong personalities. Charles Barkley, for instance.
Oh, again, and he'd probably be, that's one of my favorite, like, large personalities to have in a room. Like, they go at each other. The banter that they have is incredible.
The star of that commercial.
Hey.
Shake it. Shake it.
With
shake it.
Scott.
Now, shake it.
Yo, this man's been in China 5 times.
No, don't drag me into this.
I love it.
They had such fun personalities on the court, too.
Yeah, and I think that's what drove a lot of their success, is that people, their peers, their teammates, loved playing around them. And they knew that they had a very quick switch. You know, there's a fine line between, you know, having too much fun and, you know, going to work and being, you know, being all business. And they knew how to teeter along that while encouraging everybody to give their best self.
But again, talking about big personalities, going to Dennis Rodman. It's another great player of all time that...
I can't believe that would slip my mind to start off. Like, Dennis Rodman was the personality of the 90s.
Long time. I mean, his outfits, talk about fits back in the day. If you want to go back, we can start with him.
I tell you what, his fashion looking now is definitely something that you would actually see.
You would see somebody wearing that right now.
Easy.
Easy. And on the court, again, his personality on the court was crazy. I mean, Dennis Rodman, you never knew what you were going to get with him. And that's what made his play fun. Like, I love those kind of guys.
What about the current NBA right now? Who would be the biggest personality that you would kind of feel would fit that bill?
I mean, I'm going to go from a fashion standpoint because that is what I do, and I'm going to take Russ.
Russ.
I mean, his personality is huge and loud on the court as well, but from a fashion standpoint, personality-wise, Russ is leading the pack, and I think that's great.
And I love that because I'm a little, not a fashion guru, but I like to dabble in a little bit of fashion. I like my nice things. And his style is so progressive, and I absolutely love it. And one thing that I love, you know, from personality aspect, you know, having that wry motion is such a huge part of personality. And he probably plays with the biggest in this past decade, as far as emotion is concerned. Every possession he's on the court, he's busting his butt. And when he does something like a dunk, he literally puts all his effort in his celebration, more so than the dunk itself. We've seen it now.
Right.
Big personalities have been able to translate into the commentating aspect, commentating field. Who do you think now, current NBA player, would be able to make that transition to an NBA commentator?
For me, I mean, I had a chance to talk to Kuzma, and he's so well poised for such a young individual. So I think he would be great behind a booth right now.
For me, I'd have to go with Joel Embiid. I think he is going to be a large personality like Shaq. And he's gonna have
a ton
of presence.
Yes.
And by the time he gets done, I know he'll want to be involved with the sport as much as possible.
You know, he's behind his broadcasters doing dances all the time. He's great.
So you know that he wants to stay within the basketball limelight. And I'm excited to see him kind of, I want to see him transition. I think he'll probably be the best fit for it. I'm curious to see what people say in the comments. I know I'm sticking with Joel. You're sticking with Kuzma.
Stick with Kuzma.
We'll see what everyone says. Subscribe to NBA Playmakers and make sure you ring that bell. Enable those notifications so that way we can drop you more fire content. Be able to see it below, but ring that bell right now.